Hello children, welcome back to Umar Talks, Standard 11th Biology, 3rd chapter, okay, Plant Kingdom, and today we are going to do pteridophytes and gymnosperms. I hope you are watching all the videos properly, okay, Plant Kingdom, algae we have already done, then the second one we did fungi and bryophytes we finished, okay, go through all the videos, quite important chapter, okay, and today we are going to do pteridophytes and gymnosperms. I have already made two columns so that I don't leave anything, okay, and you get it completely. Now children, pteridophytes are the plants, the first vascular tissues, the plants with first, the first plants you can say with vascular tissues, okay, and as soon as we talk about vascular tissues, you understand very well that the tree may be a tall one, okay, with the xylem and phloem. So here, and they are normally quite many of them serve medicinal purposes. So medicinal purposes, soil binders, because they'll have tap roots, and then they can hold the plant firmly to the soil. Okay, and first terrestrial with vascular tissues. Then again a very important part, that the dominant main plant. If you remember when we were talking bryophytes, okay, we talked about sporophytic generation and gametophytic. I'm going to do alternation of generation in the next thing. Okay, so do watch that video also. Now I'll not go into further detail over here. So dominant main plant in pteridophytes is sporophytes, while in bryophytes it was gametophytes. So just remember it. Okay, dominant, the main plant body is sporophytic. And when we talk about sporophyte over here in pteridophytes, okay, the plant body is differentiated into root, stem and leaves. We can see root, stem and leaves, okay, and the leaves normally, they are very small in Selaginella. Selaginella is a pteridophyte, and the leaves are very small, and that is known as microsporophylls. Got it? And in Equisetum, the leaves are large enough, and it is known as macrosporophylls. Okay, so microsporophylls, macrosporophylls are the leaves which are present in the sporophyte. Now, when we start with a ray diagram, okay, sporophyte, as I told you, that sporophyte is the main plant body, the dominant plant body. So sporophytes, okay, sporophytes will bear sporangia, and these sporangia are contained in sporophylls. Okay, sporophylls, we will have sporangia, megasporangia and microsporangia, that is female spores and male spores. So sporangia will be contained in sporophylls. Sporophylls are leaf-like structures, as it is microsporophylls, okay, for micro or macro. Mega it will be for female and micro will be for male. Please have it in your mind, micro for male and mega for female. So when I talk about sporangia, sporangia also will be of two kinds, male and female. Microsporangia, megasporangia. So here I am talking just general, that sporangia will be contained in sporophylls. Okay, and sporophylls, how they are arranged in a cone shaped structure. In the book, okay, the diagram is there. You can see that diagram, this particular diagram, children, this particular diagram. Just look at this diagram. You can see the cone or strobilus on the top. So this is the strobilus, okay, and the sporophylls are arranged on it in the form of cone or strobilus. So that is what it says. And this strobilus, okay, up till here it is. So these sporangia, normally it is the main function to bear spores. And how are the spores formed? The spores are formed by the process of meiotic division, meiosis. Okay, so the spores become N chromosome number. The spores are with N chromosome number. And the meiosis kis mein hota hai? That is spore mother cell. Okay, sporangias will have spore mother cells. Spore mother cells mein meiotic division hoga, and that will give rise to, that will give rise to the spores with N chromosome number. Okay, and these spores, okay, they will germinate. Ab ye spores germinate hoga, and that will give rise to a photosynthetic gametophyte, which will be green in color. Okay, and it is also known as prothallus over here, children. Gametophyte will be known as prothallus. And this prothallus will bear the male, you can say, reproductive organ, that is antheridia, and female will bear female reproductive organ, that is archegonia. Okay, so the antheridia and archegonia, that is antheridia will bear antherozoids, that is the male, you can say, gamete. Okay, antheridia will bear antherozoids and archegonia will bear what? Egg. Okay, so antherozoids and egg they both fuse and they form zygote. And this zygote again will germinate into sporophyte, multicellular sporophyte. So this is the complete life cycle once more, because it is very, 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 very important. Okay, so we start from sporophyte. Sporophytes, okay, bears sporangia. Sporangia contains sporophylls. Okay, sporophylls bears stromal or cone, and this has spores. So this sporangia, directly you can say spores, but if you come like this, it is good. And sporangias, which bear spore mother cells, undergo meiotic division to give spores with N chromosome number. And this germinates to give rise to gametophyte. Okay, gametophyte, which is green in color, photosynthetic gametophyte. This is also known as prothallus. Now this prothallus bears the male reproductive organ and the female reproductive organ. That is antheridia and archegonia. Antheridia bears antherozoids, that is the male gamete, and archegonia bears the egg. Both of them fuse and form zygote. And this particular zygote, children, this is what is sporophyte, germinates into multicellular sporophyte. So, फिर से क्या होगा? ये cycle repeat होगा, फिर से यहाँ जाएगा. फिर sporophyte, sporangia. So, this is the whole cycle in pteridophytes. This is what is pteridophyte. Got it? Let's come to gymnosperms. Now, gymnosperms normally they are naked seed plants. Okay, because the seeds are formed after fertilization, post fertilization. Okay, and they remain uncovered. One species is this Cichia. Okay, so this Cichia is the tallest tree in gymnosperms. Okay, and they have taproots. And taproots, when we talk about pinus, pinus root has got mycorrhiza association. Mycorrhiza association is the root of the pinus has fungal association and it forms mycorrhiza. Okay, so this mycorrhiza association in pinus, in cycas it is coralloid root. Okay, so the difference may be asked, what is the difference between mycorrhizal root and coralloid root? So you should be, coralloid is L-O-I-D. Got it? So coralloid root, it means it contains nitrogen fixing bacteria, that is cyanobacteria. So the cycas root will have cyanobacteria's association also. Leaves in gymnosperms may be simple or compound. It means it may be one leaf or gulab ki patti jaise dekha hai na ki ek aur usme se 2, 4, 6 aur ek end mein. To usko compound leaf bolte hain. So it may be that or it may be single leaf as in China rose. Okay. Then it has got a very thick cuticle. Kyun thick cuticle? So that lots of transpiration does not take place. Quite a lot of water is not lost. Okay, so thick cuticle, sunken stomata, reason wahi hai, stomata ekdam layer pe nahi rahega, andar ki taraf sunken rahega, aur leaves will be needle in order to reduce the surface area for transpiration. Theek hai, uske baad yahan pe heterospores hote hain, dono female spore aur male spore, microspore aur megaspore dono alag alag shapes ke hote hain. So heterospores, okay, and they are with N chromosome number. So here it is said, we'll talk about both, okay. So here this N, micros and megaspores, you can say both of them are with N chromosome number. That is hold. Wo kiske andar rehta hai? Sporangia ke andar rehta hai. Sporangia, sporophylls, as we did over here, sporophylls, okay. And sporophylls, cones, okay. Cones are containing sporophylls. That is the whole story about micro. And when we talk about here, the heterospores, MMC, okay, that is the microspore mother cell. Kaise hota hai? Microspore mother cell, okay, that gives 4 megaspores. Meiosis hota hai, toh aapko hamesha samajh mein aata hai, beta. Mitosis mein 2 daughter cells are formed and in meiosis, 4 daughter cells are formed. So, yahan pe, jaise meiosis hoga, 4 megaspores are formed and this is contained. Kiske andar ho megaspores rahega? Megasporangium ke andar. Megasporangium will contain all the 4 megaspores. Okay. And one of that megaspore is functional. Baki 3 are degenerate ho jayega. Only one of the megaspore is functional and that gives rise to the female gametophyte. Got it? So this was gymnosperms. Let me see if I have left anything. Okay. Yes, what is there is, children, that the megasporangium, when we talk about this, the female दिस बेज एंथेरिडियम आर्किगोनियम जो हमने बोला है आर्किगोनियम बेज एग ओके एंड दी स्पोर्स ओके दे आर रिलीज्ड इन टू द वॉटर ओके एंड फाइनली दे फ्लोट एंड दे रीच अप टू द सर्फेस दैट इज वॉट हैपन्स ओवर हियर दे आर रिलीज फ्रॉम द माइक्रोस्पोरेंजियम एंड दे आर कैरिड इन एयर करेंट्स एयर में है तो एयर करेंट्स वॉटर में है तो वॉटर करेंट्स ओके पॉलिनेशन के जो अलग अलग मेथड्स हैं वो है सो विद दैट आई होप यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड बिकॉज द अदर पार्ट आई हैव मेड यू अंडरस्टैंड ओवर हियर ये यहाँ समझ में आ जाएगा न्यूसिलस इज अनदर टर्म न्यूसिलस इज नॉर्मली टू प्रोवाइड न्यूट्रिशन टू द ग्रोइंग एम्ब्रियो ठीक है तो न्यूट्रिशन का वो वाला फंक्शन है उसका आई होप इट इज वेरी वेरी क्लियर ओके सो वेन द मेल गैमेट्स द पोलन ग्रेन्स आर रिलीज ओके दे आर नॉट ऑन द सेम प्लांट दे आर टू डिफरेंट प्लांट्स सो वेन द मेल गैमेट्स द पोलन ग्रेन्स आर रिलीज दे विल एंटर इन टू द आर्किगोनियम कंटेनिंग दैट ओव्यूल ओके एंड ओव्यूल यानी एग एंड इट विल गो एंड फ्यूज एंड फॉर्म द जाइगोट सो दैट इज वॉट इज इन द this thing and that develops into embryo and the ovules develop into seeds okay so this is what is the gymnosperms so hope you must have understood okay completely new to you go through the video and go through this textbook also okay and let me know if you have any doubts I'll clear it okay so do keep watching the videos and yes one more topic is left just in the next alternation of generation again a very important topic so do keep watching the videos and again I tell you children that if you have not subscribed to the channel do subscribe the channel and share it with your friends yes quite many of you keep asking me that this particular topic is where so only if you have not subscribed you have this problem children if you subscribe you can always go to my channel you can go to the playlist you can look for the chapter which you want and you can look for the topic which you want to see So please do that. Thank you. Thank you very much.